It's Eric back at the Naturopath. Thank you for coming back to my channel. Here's an interesting question from a subscriber. Eric, how can I use or benefit from an omega-3 fish oil to build my gut wall really strong? I've got leaky gut syndrome. How can I make it stronger? Is omega-3 good? Omega-3 is one of the best supplements you can take. I've been long a fan of omega-3, okay? So then why don't I promote it on my channel? Why don't I have any omega-3 products? Well, I'm working on it, okay? But it takes time to source the right kind of omega-3, right? Many years ago, when I had a company in New Zealand, which I sold out to a partner, I spent a long time studying omega-3 lipids, looking at the different fats, and I formed a relationship, a professional relationship with a lady down in the South Island, who is a PhD in molecular, I think it's molecular biochemistry, with a particular interest in lipids and fats. Now this woman, man, she was weird to talk to, like she was almost like a robot, like, talk about Asperger's syndrome. As you may have worked out, I've got a sort of a bit Asperger'sy myself, but this woman was on a whole new level, okay? Like, quite a hot-looking lady, pulling out spreadsheets with terms I'd never heard of before, and like words that I didn't even know existed, okay? Really over the top. But she had a real fascination for fish oils, and she knew her stuff. And basically what I gleaned from my many conversations with her, that the shitty oils, that they're not good ones to have, are really the sardine oils and the fishes that live in the higher, in the top strata, okay? They're easy to scoop out the water, easier to harvest, and easier to process. But as she always said to me, traditionally, fish oils always were cod or fish in the deep strata. They live 400 meters plus down, 800 meters, even a kilometer, which is almost a mile down under the water. And she said, if you think about it, Eric, it makes sense. These fishes live in the coldest, darkest, most, you know, incredible environments. So their bodies have to be made. You have an ability to protect them, okay? Particularly with those crushing pressures and intense stresses that they face. So she said they produce a fat, unlike anchovies or sardines, that's so protective of them. So cod liver oil is the one that you want. Now cod liver oil also is an incredibly complex molecular chemistry. If we can pull cod liver oil out on a spreadsheet, okay, we're looking at hundreds and hundreds of types of lipids in that oil. Yeah? Now you may have heard of the terms DHA and EPA. These are the two common fractions, okay? But it goes far further than that. It goes way further than that. If we look at shark liver oil, for example, shark liver oil, Mako shark, has anti-cancer properties about it. Now that may seem like, you know, some dumb statement I'm making here, but studies from South Korea and Japan have shown that, you know, certain components in shark oil, but also in cod oil, have got the ability, okay, to seriously reduce inflammation and also to help to stop cancer from forming in the body. So should you take shark oil every day? I think cod liver oil is the one to take. The jury's still out on the shark oil, but the cod liver oil has got a nice anti-inflammatory component about it. Studies I've looked at show the EPA component of cod oil works almost as good, if not better, than ibuprofen, than pharmaceutical medications. So people who regularly take fish oil, a quality fish oil, will definitely notice an anti-inflammatory effect. There's no doubt about it. Now, anyone who comes back and argues with me the fish oil is junk, like they used to 20 years ago now, needs to go to a psychiatrist, okay? The Cambridge studies that were conducted many years ago confirmed the effect on omega on a child's brain, okay? So if you get children, group A, give them no fish oil, group B, give them fish oil, the IQ, the intelligence quotient on the children who take the fish oil is in direct proportion to how much fish oil they have in their diet. So a child with lots and lots of fish oil in its diet, especially in a nurturing, loving environment, with a good diet generally, okay, will tend to be a smarter child than the one who's just basically given sodas and cheap, crappy margarines and things like that. It's unfair to say that, but there's absolutely 100% proof that that's a fact. Okay? So, but not only that, there are also enough studies to show that the omega-3 has significant anti-inflammatory effects. So will it be good for your digestive system? Absolutely. Will it reduce inflammation in the body? Absolutely. Will it improve the function of the brain on many levels, absolutely. Then why aren't many people taking fish oils? Well, I think a lot of people are, but unfortunately a lot of people are also taking very poor quality fish oils, rancid fish oils. When I was in the South Island, New Zealand, I sampled many different types of fish oil. So now I can smell and taste an oil and bing, I can immediately know, tell you if it's rancid or not, if it's good quality or crap quality. So there aren't many fish oils that I would really like to promote myself. So I'm still looking at a supremely good source of cod oil, probably from the Northern Hemisphere, from quite high up around Norway, would be a good one to get. So watch this space. Because I love omega-3, and I wrote widely about omega-3 in Candida Crusher. I believe everybody would benefit from 1 to 2 grams, 1 to 2,000 milligrams of fish oil per day on an ongoing basis. It's a fantastic thing to have. Autoimmune disease is mitigated by it. It reduces all parameters of autoimmune inflammation. Arthritis, leaky gut will certainly benefit from it. And it helps the gut wall on so many levels. So to answer the question, how do I use it? I would take 2 capsules a day, 2,000 milligrams with food, probably spread them out. You could build it up to 3, but 2 is probably sufficient. And just make sure that you follow an anti-inflammatory diet as well. Check on this channel, because if you do a search, you'll find my recommendations for anti-inflammatory diet. Thanks for tuning in.